Kendrick has dropped the album. Damn. And you know what we're gonna say? Damn. I feel like that was the most corny thing that I could probably think about as an intro to this video. But really and truly, realistically, damn. Like, Kendrick just... You slayed us all once again. We are slayed. As a general overview of the album, I would like to say that I appreciate the song that he has brought. He is a poet. Kendrick is a poet. K-Dot is a poet. And every time that he comes at us, it is with something real. And it is with something that somebody can relate to. Even if it's not commercial and it's not something that everyone is going to be banging to, it is something that we all know is the truth. And I want to say thank you on behalf of all of us for always speaking the truth, because you real fam and I like that about you. That being said, I usually like to start with, you know, all of the good comments before I go into what was bad, but I just need to know. I understand that the world is going through, you know, a hard time, a dark time, but everybody is so angry. Why are these rappers so mad? I personally like happy music. I like things that are true, but I also like music that makes me feel good. But then we have to think about the fact that it's not about us. It's about what they are feeling as people and what is going on. Rap is a reflection of the world, of the community. And really and truly, what is there happy to sing about? There is not a lot of happy things going on. They ain't got happy things going on in America. They may got happy things going on in Britain. So Drake could fly as far as he wants. It's generally a depressive time in the world. We want someone to pick us up, but who picks them up? And that is something that Kendrick does raise in this album. Everybody wants someone to pray for them. But who's praying for me? Who prays for the artist? Who makes the artist happy so that they can make us happy? Who? They're going through the same things as us. So I feel like everyone is saying, you know, like things are so dull, things are so dark. It's dark because it's real. And that's all I'm going to say on that. Kendrick Lamar is an artist that always likes to tell a story. And this album is really no different. When you listen to one song through to the other, you see where he's going with it. You see what's the general theme of the album. And a big theme in this album is definitely loyalty. And how you reflect on others. The effect that you have on others. And how you could change yourself to change the world. He says he thought it was the world versus me until he realized that it was me versus me. If that ain't deep, I don't know what is. A grave digger will look at that and be like, bruv. Bruv. The album is relatively short for a hip-hop album. It is 14 tracks. And it's basically 14 tracks of hardcore, in your face, legendary shit. But, this is a big but that I have about K-Dot. It's like, a lot of this is, it's rough. It is rough. It is hard to take. It's kind of hard to swallow. He's not cutting any corners. He's not sparing lives here. He is going in for the kill and he's saying exactly how he feels. And as we know, from the way that the world has gone, that generally when black people especially say exactly how they feel, they tend to be ostracized from the rest of the community. And this concerns me a little bit. Let us say, for example, in XXX, X-rated, whatever you want to call it, when this man starts to go down the line. Touch my mama, touch my sister, touch my woman, touch my daddy, touch my niece, touch my nephew, touch my brother. You should chip a nigga, then throw the floor in his lap. Matter of fact, I'm about to speak at this convention, call you back. Kendrick! Woo! No, Kendrick, yeah, it's true that if anybody mess with my family, I gain for them. But when you lay it down on the track like that, like, I felt it. I felt within myself, although I had no previous plans to assault his family, that this was not the man to assault. And I feel like that's how a lot of people sit feeling right now, but a lot of people not saying it. Kendrick said that. Kendrick did that. Okay. He addresses how males growing up in the home, how they are treated, how they're expected to do certain things, how everything is like an attack on them. And really, that leads to the whole circle of life. That is how it always will go, because his father before him probably treated him like that, and that's how he's going to treat his child. That's how his child is going to be treated. And you just feel like if you always need to be on guard as a black man. And I agree. And you know what? It ain't right. Names, the song titles, all follow the theme of kind of like personal development, kind of like, you know, at the root of who you really are. So you have like blood, you got DNA, you got elements. How do I know these things? Okay, that's not in order. It was pretty close though. You got feel and loyalty, lust and love. And I was wondering where are the rest of the seven deadly sins, but I was like, you know what? Kind of hard to write a song about gluttony, so let me just left out the man. The song, I really like DNA. I feel like DNA made the first real statement for me. However, blood really established the storyline. And I feel like if a lot of artists going on this whole story path nowadays, but we got acknowledge, and if you would know, if you were privileged to hear the masterpiece, which was Kendrick's first album, Mad City, then you would know that Kendrick was one of the first to start with this anyway. So if you want to tell stories in his tracks, tell them, K-Dot. Tell them, let them know. That being said, I thought he would have come with a fresher approach or something else that we have not seen before. Like, he was going to switch up the game. And I feel like, you know, it wasn't exactly switched because it was still the same kind of structure. But still, it was very creative. Even the title and the story and everything was pretty creative, so I'm gonna let you pass on that. On to my favorite tracks. Now, normally I choose three. I feel like I'm gonna go for four, guys. Think I'm gonna have to go for four. But I'm gonna try to get it done. We can see. Rihanna, guys. Okay, so guys, Rihanna switched up the scene. She wasn't on Drake's playlist, but she make her appearance on Damn. Now, you know how I feel about Rihanna, so you don't know that already. I was biased towards this song, but I was like, you know, keep an open mind, Sean, keep an open mind. And lucky enough, I love it. I love it. It's one of the more commercial tracks. I don't really find that the lyrics were at the forefront of this as much as, you know, other tracks on the album. However, it was a really nice track. It's really mellow. You could do a little jig. You could do a little slow wine. You could do a little grind. You can do stuff. You can do stuff to this track. If I gotta put your pick in the bitch, I'ma make it look sexy. I pull up, hop out, air out, made it look sexy. They won't take me out my element. No, take me out I'm allergic to a bitch, nigga, ay. An imaginary rich nigga, ay. Seven figures, how that slimmer than my bitch figure, ay. Going digital and physical and all y'all, ay. Watch your criminals and money in my phone calls, ay. I too am allergic to bitch niggas, just in case you were wondering. Okay. love. First of all, that guy Zachary and his voice. Let's talk about his voice. How is it so smooth? How is it so smooth? It is angelic. Like an angel has come and has embodied him when he has started to sing. I am so confused. And it was like, you know what, Zachary? I will love you. I will. And then I googled his photo on Google. Duh. And I realized that we weren't gonna work out. And that was sad. But Love is also a very commercial track. All the women are gonna love it. People are gonna love Zachary because of his immaculate voice. And you know, I really felt it in my heart that Kendrick does love someone. If someone was to write that for me, I would take them back. And I ain't really take back kind of girl. So I felt it. And I don't contemplate, I meditate, they're off your fucking head. This that put the kids to bed. This that I got realness. I just kill shit cause it's in my DNA. I just win again like Wimbledon I serve. Yeah, that's him again, the sound, the engine in is like a bird. You see fireworks and Corvette tire skirt, the boulevard. I know how you work, I know just who you are. See, use a bitch, you're on my body. Okay. DNA though, like he hit us. He was like, y'all thought it was like, you thought this album was gonna be like laid back, and then DNA. I was like, yes, Kendrick, push through. I wouldn't say that this song is the strongest on the album lyrically, but I would say that this flow combined with the lyrical content makes it definitely one of my favorites, because he is going hard. Kendrick went hard on this track. Done. Bye. Special shout out goes to Humble. Still killing it on the floor. Still killing it with the lyrics. Still killing it with the musical production. Man, where is it? I remember syrup sandwiches and gram analysis. Vanessa nigga with some counter. Humble, be humble, sit down, bitch, be humble. My full review of Humble did not upload. I'm not sure why it cut off in the middle, so sorry if you watched that and you were late. What did Shauna have to say? Basically, I said it was lit. That's all you need to do. It's lit, Kendrick is lit, his flow is fire, and I enjoyed it thoroughly. That's what you needed to know about that review. So yes, guys, that was Damn. I know you understand why I, in turn, had to say Damn. You know, he was probably looking for a title for the album, and like the producer was just like, Damn. Someone walked into the studio and was like, yeah, Kendrick, let me hear what you got to do. And he was like, all right, I'm going to play it for you. And I said, don't listen intently. And then he was like, Damn. The man was editing the final production, you know, like mixing it, the mixer. He was like, yeah, this sound good. Then he listened to all of it back and he was like, damn. One of those three scenarios I'm definitely going with. But it was an appropriate name because we're slayed. We stand here today slayed before K-Dot, the master. And I would like to say thank you for watching, guys. And let me know what you guys thought about Damn. What you thought about the album. What's your favorite song? And what are you hoping to see from Kendrick coming up in the future? Peace out.